Hey, welcome back to Rusted Horsepower. So today, in order to make my car more of a running, driving car, we're gonna put this tired 350 that I already resealed back in. Let's get to it. The driver's side mount is sandwiched with the power steering pump bracket, and originally a bolt was missing. I'm using some anti-seize on the bolts to lubricate the threads and prevent problems. These D-ring shackles are great for attaching a lift chain. I'm bringing the transmission up as high as possible to help the engine mate away from the chassis. Anti-seize is a must on rusted exhaust threads. These guide bolts I made will make mating the engine and transmission quick and easy. That way I don't have to rattle around and beat up my nice paint job. The pull strap helps keep the engine from turning sideways. Here's the scary part. We'll be right back. I needed to remove the electric fan shroud because I was using guide bolts and because of the angle I was bringing the engine in. Here I'm using those guide bolts to make the top edges meet. Then I can drop the engine mounts straight into place. Look at all this space underneath. The mounts are in a bind here, and I'm having a hard time pushing the engine into place. All made it up. With the mounts still in a bind, the bolts were having a hard time getting through. I use the lower bell housing bolts to keep the engine from pulling away. The double wobble. I am still dealing with the mounts binding right here. And a little bit more anti-seize. Thank you. Even though I love how my Chevelle looks without a hood, I decided to put it back on to keep any direct rain off the engine. Well, that wraps up the first part of my Chevelle's engine reinstall. The next part will be ready real soon. Thanks for watching, and God bless you.